fats, oils, fatty acids, saturated fats, unsaturated fats, monounsaturated, polyunsaturated, omega-3s, omega-6s, trans fats, triglycerides. They're good for you, they're bad for you, this will kill you. Oh, you should only eat animals. No, you shouldn't eat animals, you should only eat plants. Enough, okay? This video, and I've been putting off this video because it is actually very complicated, but this video is about fats and oils. Oils are just melted fats. In our diet, what they do, which ones are actually okay, which ones are really good for us and going to save our lives, and which ones are probably going to destroy our lives. Okay, so welcome to Shape Fixer. I'm Andrew Tunstall, nutrition coach, lifestyle coach, science teacher, and yes, I am sitting in a different place because in my little town in Spain, there's a fiesta today and my kitchen is very, very noisy. Right, now, before we get into this whole thing, I know there are going to be some people who will get on the comments and start to vent and offer opinions about fat and very extreme opinions, and they probably won't watch the video. So if I welcome your debate and I welcome your contribution and I'm open to science and I'm open to having a discussion, but please at least watch the video first. So what is the deal with fat? Fat generally has been demonized for a very long time, and we've been told for the last 40 or 50 years to cut fat from our diet and to have more carbohydrates, which means sugar. And yet obesity levels have skyrocketed, diabetes has skyrocketed, heart disease has skyrocketed since that time. So something isn't right. Watch my videos on sugar, watch my videos on carbohydrates, watch my video on cholesterol to just understand what these things actually mean, because we throw these terms around and we don't know what they mean. So today I'm going to help you understand what a fatty acid is. Fatty acids are the complicated molecules that make up all the fats that we get. Now, this is a chain of carbon atoms. Okay, these black things are carbon atoms, and each carbon atom can make four connections. It can bind four times. So this is binding with a carbon and another carbon and another carbon, and coming off the side, maybe a hydrogen goes there. Typically it would be hydrogen, can be oxygen, it can be a lot of other things. And a fatty acid is a long chain of carbon atoms like this. Longer than this, they can be really long. And that's all they really are. But there are many different types of fatty acids because they can be different lengths and the nature of the bonds can be different. So the first big distinction is the distinction between saturated fatty acids and unsaturated fatty acids. This is a saturated fatty acid. You can see that there's something bonded to each carbon at each point. There's nothing available to, there's no place available to add anything else on. Okay, so this is saturated. It means it's full. If we removed, say, a hydrogen there and a hydrogen here, and we took another, let's just get rid of this one because I need a spare part, and we connected like this, we have a double bond here between two of the carbons. That is what is called an unsaturated fatty acid. So let's just pop something on there. All right, everything is taken, except that this one is double. So you could actually open it up, you'd still have the same chain, and you could put another hydrogen there and another hydrogen here. That is therefore an unsaturated fatty acid. That's all it means. Saturated fatty acids, generally speaking, come from animals, and they tend to be solid at room temperature. So that would be like fat on a piece of beef or bacon fat. Unsaturated fatty acids, which are liquid at room temperature normally, come from plant sources. So that's the first big distinction. Right, so let's talk about saturated fatty acids, the animal ones. That we have been told for a long time we need to cut out and it's very bad and it leads to cardiovascular disease. Well, it doesn't. We've been told for years that it will increase your cholesterol. And that is true because cholesterol is produced by your liver and it's a very important molecule, not only as part of the structure of your cell membranes and your nervous system and your brain, but it is also used to carry fatty acids around in your blood. So clearly, if you eat more fat, you need more cholesterol, so your liver will produce more cholesterol to do its job. If you think of your blood system as a motorway or system, like a three-lane motorway, and the trucks are your cholesterol molecules carrying your fats up and down the motorway, if the motorway is damaged and two lanes have to close and you've only got one lane open, you get a backlog of trucks, you get a traffic jam, and that traffic jam stops the flow of goods through the motorway. What's the solution? Ban the trucks. That doesn't help. The solution is to fix the highway and open up the lanes and keep it flowing, keep it healthy. So your problem for arterial blockages and cardiovascular disease is not the trucks on the motorway. It's the motorway not operating properly and being restricted and closed down. And that happens because of sugar. Sugar damages your blood vessels and creates these blockages. It's not the cholesterol's fault. It's not the truck's fault. Okay, go and watch my video on cholesterol. I don't want to get into that too much right now because this is not a video about sugar. This is a video about fat. So really, saturated fat or animal fats, there are two types, one in meat and one in dairy. The type in meat is actually fine. It gives a great energy source. The type in dairy, which is your cream on your dairy, actually has quite good anti-inflammatory properties. So as long as you're not dairy intolerant, it's actually quite good for you. You can get by without saturated fat. You don't have to eat it if you're getting enough fats from your other sources and the unsaturated fats. But saturated fat generally is not the devil that it has been made out to be. So let's talk about unsaturated fats. And this is where it gets complicated because there are so many different types of unsaturated fats. So I'm going to try and keep them to their broad subtypes. In the notes below the video, I am going to make a summary of all this with bullet points and the names of the different types of fats, the types of foods you can get them in, and why they are important or dangerous, so that you can use that as a reference, okay? So bear with me, and you don't have to try and memorize everything I'm saying as I say it. Unsaturated fats from plants, generally liquids at room temperature. And there are two broad subdivisions of unsaturated fats, and you will have heard of monounsaturated and polyunsaturated. Now, you remember this molecule, unsaturated because it still has a carbon double bond. It's only got this one. So that is a monounsaturated. If it had another one here, it would be polyunsaturated, which means more than one. Okay, again, that's all it is. The monounsaturated, the main one in your body, is omega-9 fatty acid, which your body can manufacture. So it's not considered an essential fatty acid because you don't have to eat it. You can make it. But you can eat it too. And the best source of omega-9 is olive oil. And olive oil will improve your liver function. It will improve your mitochondrial function. And it is also very good at increasing your insulin sensitivity. So it will combat the development of diabetes or insulin resistance, and in the process, help prevent obesity. So olive oil is really good for you. The only thing you've got to be careful of with olive oil is if you cook with olive oil, cook over a low heat. If it goes over 165 degrees Celsius, which is, I don't know, 320 about Fahrenheit, it will turn into something called the trans fat, which is actually really dangerous. And I'll get on to trans fats. So you don't use olive oil for cooking if you're going to cook in a high heat. Rather use butter. But olive oil to put on your food is very good for you. So that's the monounsaturated. The polyunsaturateds, and this is where you have so many different types. The most important one is omega-3. Your omega-3 oils are absolutely the most important fat type that you need in your body. It's an essential oil. You cannot make it. You have to eat it. And there are three different kinds of omega-3s. I'm not going to go into their names. One of them comes from plants. So you can get it from eating walnuts and seeds. It also comes, you also get it in eggs. The other types of omega-3 only come from fish or fish oil. And we don't get enough omega-3s generally in our diet. It's especially difficult for if you're a vegan, because if you're vegan and you won't eat fish, then unless the only other place you can get it from is the seaweed or the algae that the fish eat, because the fish don't make omega-3, they get it from their algae. So you'd have to eat quite a lot of seaweed to get your omega-3 oils, or you could have an omega-3 supplement, but the problem with that is it's fish oil and it comes from fish. So that's a challenge if you're vegan. If you're not a vegan, it's not so bad. You have sardines maybe twice a week, or oily fish, or a supplement, an omega-3 supplement. But you need to increase your omega-3s. Your omega-3s will make your heart healthy, will help prevent Alzheimer's, and it's a very, very good anti-inflammatory. The other type of polyunsaturated oil is omega-6. Omega-6s are also very important because omega-6s protect your body's ability to inflame, because you do need some inflammation. You need to be able to have an inflammatory response when you get an infection or an injury, because it helps you to heal or cure or fight off an infection. If you don't have enough omega-6, you won't be able to do that. But we do have a lot of omega-6 in our diet, to the point where our inflammation levels are actually too high because we have too much omega-6, and omega-6 mostly comes from seed oils. So what we need to do is try to control our omega-6 and try to increase our omega-3, because the ratio should be anywhere between 1:1 and 4:1, okay, 4 being the omega-6s, but really our diet tends to be anything from 20 to 25:1. So it's completely wrong. We have too much inflammation and we're too low in omega-3s. So omega-6s are fine, but we need to try and control them. Then the last fat that you really want to stay away from is called a trans fat. And that again has got to do with the bonding and the angles of the bonds in the fat. And trans fats we cannot break down. We don't have the enzyme to break apart the bonds in a trans fat. So they're poisonous and they sit in our liver and they build up there and we develop fatty liver disease and heart disease. Trans fats that we get in our diet are mostly because the oils have been treated chemically in a factory to make them last longer on the shelf and in the shops. So things like margarine, which should actually be liquid, they've been altered so that they can be solid, so they're easy to pack and easy to transport and easy to spread on your bread, which you shouldn't be eating because that's sugar. And they are very, very poisonous. So we need to completely avoid the poisonous trans fats. All right, so there you have it. Trans fats, bad. Don't eat them. Omega-6s, they're okay, but try to not have too many. Omega-3s, absolutely vital. You don't get enough, increase your omega-3s. Saturated fat, animal fat, is fine, don't panic about it. And omega-9s, which your body can make, but you can eat them too, comes from olive oil, which has other benefits with increasing your liver function and your mitochondrial function. Okay, so there you go. That's a lot in as short a time as I could squeeze it. I tried to stay away from a lot of the biochemistry and a lot of the science. If you want to understand more about that, I will put links in the video to some really good books about it that you can buy and read. They are on Amazon or in your local bookshop, I guess. And that's it. So thank you for watching. Please subscribe. Please share this video. And please, if you're going to comment, watch the video first and read the video notes. And then I welcome any comments. And if I've missed anything or I've got anything wrong, I would love to hear from you. And we will see if we can correct it. Thank you very much.